Morning, my morning, he awakens me, opens my ear, awakes my understanding. Morning, my morning, he awakens me, ready to learn from him.
Good morning and welcome to Morning by Morning on Wednesday, May the 19th, 2021. We continue our theme of flowers and plants and trees with the olive tree, very common tree in the Middle East and the Mediterranean, a tree of warmer climates, and one of its crops, grown for food, for oil, for the wood, grown less formally for shade and beauty, its branches signifying peace. In fact, we could spend a couple of weeks just on olive trees, but we're going to focus on the oil that comes from the tree. It was used for healing. Remember the story Jesus told of a man who was injured, and a Samaritan came to where he was, and when he saw him, had compassion on him, bound up his wounds, pouring oil and wine on them. It was also used to pour on a person's head to set them apart as kings and priests. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed David in the midst of his brothers, and the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon David from that day forward. It's a symbol of blessing. How good and pleasant it is when God's people live together in unity. It is like precious oil poured on the head, running down on the beard, running down on Aaron's beard, down the collar of his robe. There the Lord bestows his blessing, even life evermore. And you can imagine that oil flowing right down, the blessing of God. It was used as everyday cleansing. The psalm tells us that the Lord brings forth oil to make people's faces shine. And I remember living in Sudan, and there was a Sudanese lady came in once a week to help us clean the house. It usually got really dusty when there were dust storms. And I remember one day I'd come in after work and she was still there. She had just come out. She'd done her work. She'd had a shower and she came into the kitchen and she brought out the olive oil. And I wondered what she was going to do with the olive oil. I wondered if she's going to make a salad or fry an egg or something. But no, she poured the oil, olive oil from the bottle on her hands, and she just rubbed her face with it. And it did indeed make her face shine. As we know, oil was used for light. Command the Israelites to bring you clear oil of pressed olives for the light, so that the lamps may be kept burning continually. And even as we read, it's as a symbol of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he anointed, he poured oil on me to preach the gospel to the poor. One of my favourite pictures in the Bible is in Zechariah. It's a picture of two olive trees and a lamp and bowl in the middle. And these living trees are rooted, and the oil that comes from them symbolises the everlasting presence of the Holy Spirit flowing through God's people. And what does it mean? The angel that describes the picture in the book of Zechariah says, this is its meaning. Not by might, nor by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. A beautiful picture of God's Spirit flowing continuously through his people. And as we come towards celebrating Pentecost and the coming of the Holy Spirit in the church, it's good to take time to think about this verse, look at this picture, and the pouring out, the continual anointing of the Holy Spirit on all believers, not by might, not by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord. May indeed the Holy Spirit fall afresh on us. Amen. And our prayer today is also our song, when we pray and ask God that the Holy Spirit would fall afresh on me.
Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Break me, melt me, mold me, fill me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me. Break me, melt me, mold me, fill me. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh on me.